founded this festival 21 years ago to bring the performing arts alive and well to Essexville. I was only able to do that with the support of the community. You have passed a major bond issue. The auditorium is next. $300,000 will be put into this room. Thank you very much. To my parents, I can't do this without you. You show your support for excellence by helping your children thrive in performing arts from the bottom of my heart. Thank you very much. To the directors from the schools that have traveled hundreds of miles to be here, stay overnight, plan a trip to kids, know what that's like, be quite a logistical problem at times, but you've done it here at Excellence for your kids, provide an opportunity for your kids to have memories. This is something you'll talk about at your 20-year class reunion. Thank you. My definition of a quality school district is how full the parking lot is on a weekend. Last night, we had more kids at Garber between this festival and the basketball game than at 10 Garber. The parking lot's been full every weekend only because you care, and I think
I understand.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is a world that I hope never happens to you. George Orwell's 1984.
Good morning, comrade.
Good morning, Garber Presents.
And how was the news this morning?
Oh, just the usual. Another victory for our troops in India.
Oh, that's very good. The war should be over soon. It's dragged on long enough now.
Attention, comrades. This morning, three spies confessed to being members of the Goldstein Brotherhood of Traitors. This afternoon, at 1700 hours, they will be hanged in Victory Square. All party members are invited to attend. Here's more glorious news. We have won the battle for production. The Ministry of Money has announced the overproduction of shoes by 483,963,202 pairs for the second half of the 6th 30-year plan. Our standard of living has risen 20% over the past year. All over Oceania, workers are parading through the streets with banners, voicing their gratitude to Big Brother for the new, happy life which his wise leadership has bestowed upon us. All hail Big Brother!
All hail Big Brother!
All love Big Brother!
All love Big Brother!
A little late this morning, aren't you, comrade?
Well, they haven't brought the morning's work around yet.
You missed the morning newscast. I should report you.
What's in the news, Parsons?
As I was coming in, they were announcing still another victory. I'm not sure just where.
So you were late too?
Oh, of course, I was here. I heard the news, all of it.
Good morning, comrades. Big Brother has plenty for you to do today. Comrade Sam, this is for you. You were ordered to have it translated into Newspeak no later than 12:30 hours. Comrade Parsons, nothing for you.
Nothing? I don't understand.
You were ordered to report to the Bureau of Hate. You have been reassigned.
Reassigned, but why?
Don't ask me why, comrade. Ask the thought police. Have you been making mistakes? Have you been indulging in crime?
No, certainly not. That's a terrible suggestion. The Bureau of Hate. It must be a promotion. That's right, Smith. I'm being promoted.
I wouldn't know.
They wouldn't reassign someone who failed them. There isn't a more devoted party member than I in all of Oceania.
Just be there by 09:30. They'll be expecting you. Comrade Smith, this is for you. A whole month's worth of battle torch in the time.
Thank you. Oh, wait a minute. You forgot Withers.
Withers? I have nothing here for any Withers.
Well, surely you do. Bob Withers? The man who's been working with us, next to me. Bob Withers.
There's no such name on my route list. Good morning, comrades.
Did you know about this person?
Yes.
Well, then what?
He's not here. Let's not talk about it. That's all we need to know.
Then he was...
Yes.
Attention! Attention, all comrades under the age of 60. Calisthenics. Out of your seats and onto your feet. Calisthenics.
That's better. All rest. That'll be all for this morning. Victory coffee. Victory coffee, comrades. Big Brother's compliments, and it's time for your morning stimulation. Get your coffee, comrades. Praise the bounty of Big Brother. Have you heard about the 2 minutes hate this morning? I'm told it's something special. Something plus good. Double plus good.
Well, it's always something special.
We need something special. It keeps us interested in the war.
That's right, Smith. We who don't have the privilege of fighting on the front lines must fight the best we can here at home.
Well, what's the hate today?
I hear it's going to be Goldstein himself. Isn't that exciting?
Well, double plus exciting.
Well, drink up. Next coffee period is 1100 hours, comrades. Get your refills then.
This stuff gets worse and worse every day. I can hardly drink it.
That verges on crime cake, comrade. Really, it's quite good. Oh, I always feel much better after my victory coffee. A lot calmer, you know, and more at ease about things.
I wonder what they put in this stuff. I say, Smith, you know what they put in this?
I wouldn't know. I'd never drink it anyway.
Whatever it isn't coffee.
You're finding fault with Big Brother. That's crime thing. I had better report you to the Thought Police.
Attention! Attention for a member of the inner party.
This is Comrade O'Brien. Hey, Smith, sir. That one, number 6079.
Thank you. Turn the telescreen down.
Did you mean to turn it off?
Of course not, just turn it down.
Yes, sir.
I don't want any interruptions. It's all right if I turn the telescreen off. You must remember that although you cannot hear it, and can only see the picture of Big Brother, it can still both hear and see you. Many thought criminals have been trapped by that. Comrade Smith, I would like to talk to you. Yes, sir. Of course, Comrade O'Brien. I'll see it doesn't happen again. I wasn't that late, just a few minutes, that's all, really.
Never mind that now. There are more important things than lateness. I'd like to be alone with Comrade Smith. I was reading one of your newspeak articles at times. You take a scholarly interest in newspeak.
Well, it's not my subject. Science the expert. I've never had anything to do with the actual construction of the language.
You're too modest, Smith. You write it very elegantly. That is not only my own opinion. I was speaking recently to a friend of yours. His name has slipped my memory for the moment, but...